Hello and welcome to Pabbly Connect. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can completely automate the process of creating the Instagram post using Canva and sharing the same post on your Instagram profile from Google Spreadsheet. So using ChatGPT, I have basically created hundreds of quotes with their author name, and I have added all of these quotes, author name, and the date on which I want to publish these quotes into a Google Spreadsheet. And from this Google Sheet, I've automated the process of creating the post from Canva using a template which we have created, uploading the post image in our Dropbox account, saving it in Dropbox, and sharing the same post on Instagram. And we have done this with this simple Pabbly Connect automation workflow. Now don't worry, you don't have to create this whole automation workflow from the scratch. You will get the clone link of this same automation in the description of the video like this. Just click on this link and you can clone the same workflow into your own Pabbly Connect account. And after cloning the workflow, you just have to update the connection of Google Sheet, Canva, Dropbox and Instagram into their respective steps and then start using this automation for absolutely free. Now here in this workflow, the first step, the trigger step which we have selected is scheduled by Pabbly. So I want to create the Instagram post and share it every day. And in my Google Sheet, I have added the post date as well. So we want this automation workflow to be executed to trigger every day at a specific time. So we have scheduled this automation workflow over here. If you want, you can change the schedule frequency as per your choice, as per your requirement as well. After scheduling this workflow, after triggering this workflow, in the next step, we have added a feature, a module of Pabbly Connect called Date Time Formatter. And using date time formatter, we are adding today's date, the current date in this automation workflow. And in the response, we have received that as well. After getting the current date from our Google spreadsheet in the next step, we have used the action step of lookup spreadsheet row. And using this action, we have to basically get the quote and the author, the data of that row in which we have that date. So today is 12th of August. We have the 12th of August in row number 2. So today when this automation workflow ran, it took this particular quote and this author in the response. So using this action, we have basically received the response of the quote and the author from the Google Sheet for that particular day. After getting the Instagram post content from our Google Sheet of that day, we want to send that same content to the template which we have created in Canva. So in the next step, we have selected Canva as the action application and create design autofill job as the action event. And using this particular action, we have basically selected a brand template. So to create the dynamic Instagram post, first we have to create a brand template in our Canva account. And then after that, we have to basically use the bulk create app to make this template dynamic. Now, if you want a dedicated video, if you want to learn how you can create this brand template and use this kind of template with Pabbly Connect automation, we already have a dedicated video live on the channel. You can refer to that video and basically create a dynamic template in your Canva account and use it inside Pabbly Connect. But here in this action step, you just have to create the template, select the same template over here, and you have to give this type template a name. The new post which we are creating, you have to give it a name. So I have given the quote, the actual quote which we have received from Google Sheet in the previous step. We have mapped the same response over here and given the quote as the title of the post. Then here in this template, we have two dynamic fields, the quote and the author. So we have basically configured these two dynamic fields. And if you need any kind of help setting up this action event, you can basically refer to the video in the I button or in the description box below, which we have on Canva. Then after that, after sending the quote and the author name to Canva and creating a new post out of it, here in the response, you can see we have received the response and it is a success response. This means using this action, a new post is created. This is the design ID of the new dynamic post which we have created, and this is a link. Here you can just copy this link, paste it in a new tab, and you can see in the same template which we have in Canva, we have added the quote and the author from our Google spreadsheet and created a new post out of it. Now after creating this post, we want the JPG file or the image file for this post as well. So in the next step, we have once again used Canva over here, and this time we have basically used this action of download design as image JPG. In this action event, what we have to do, we just have to enter the design ID. So here in the response of previous step, we have received the design ID. Just map the same design ID from the previous step over here. Select the quality as 100, export quality as pro, and enter the size of the post which you want to export. In response, using this action, after clicking on save and send test request, in response, you will get this job ID. Now basically, Canva has started exporting this particular image from our Canva account. Now we have to allow Canva some time. So I have added a delay over here in this automation workflow, and we have added a delay of 1 minute. So we will just wait for 1 minute. The automation will be delayed for 1 minute. And after 1 minute, once again, using the action step of Canva, that is get export link, we are going to give the same job ID from the previous step of download design over here in export ID field. And after that, after clicking on save and send test request in response, we have received the link, the URL of the same post which we have basically created. We will just open this URL in a new tab, and you can see we have the JPG image for the same post. After getting the image, we want to save this post on our Dropbox account into a specific folder. So we have used the Dropbox action step of upload file and uploaded the image in our Dropbox account just for backup. And then finally, we have used Instagram for Business in this automation. Using this action event, basically we are posting the same image which we have created using Canva and basically creating a post on our Instagram account. And in the caption of this post, I'm adding the same code, and after a hyphen, I'm adding the same author name as well. If you want, you can add some other caption in your Google spreadsheet and basically map that caption, the response of that caption over here, and share the Instagram post with that particular caption. After clicking on save and send test request and sharing the post on Instagram, I wanted to update the link of this Dropbox file, this Dropbox image, and the status of this Instagram post which we have published in my Google spreadsheet over here. Like, the status should be updated to published and image URL should be added from Dropbox. So I have added this action step of Google Sheet, but this is optional. If you want, you can just avoid this step as well. And here I'm updating my Google Sheet spreadsheet row. We have basically mapped the row index from the previous step of Google Sheet lookup spreadsheet row. And then we have basically updated the status as published and mapped the response of file URL from the Dropbox responses. And after clicking on save and send test request, this action step is also added, and we have updated the status and image of the post which we have created. So using this automation, the automation workflow will start every day at a specific time which we have selected. It will get the code and the author name for that particular date from our Google Sheet, send the same details to Canva, and create a new post out of it. The new post will be saved in our Dropbox folder, and then the same post will be shared on our Instagram profile as well, that too automatically without any manual effort. And you can completely automate the process of creating Instagram posts from Google Sheets using Canva and Dropbox inside Pabbly Connect automation. So as I told you, you don't have to create the whole automation from the scratch. You can just clone the same automation workflow from the description box below. And if you want a step-by-step tutorial on setting up this automation, you can always write us in the comment box below. So I hope this video was helpful to you, and if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, share with this video with your team members and others, and don't forget to subscribe to Pabbly. So this is it for today's video. Thank you. Have a great day.